I'm here with Sia Raj Purohit, who is a program manager here at Udacity, managing the App Entrepreneurship Nano Degree. Thank you so much for talking to us today, Sia.
Thanks, David. Good to be here.
So Sia is an experienced online student as well as a manager of online programs. So I wanted to start off by asking you, what are some of the exciting kind of new things that are coming out in online education that some of our students might not yet be aware of?
So a year ago, Harvard Business School launched a program called HBX Core. So what is really interesting about this is that instead of disrupting its like core business, which is like to graduate students with an MBA degree, instead they're extending the pipeline by targeting students who are undergraduates or just before the MBA stage to teach them like critical skills in like economics, business analytics, and financial accounting. So these are the three classes that HBX offers. And it's a 3-month program. It costs about $1,500 to $1,800. And students complete it in cohorts, essentially. So each cohort consists of about 600 students. And they go through the program and gain these skills. And then take a final exam at a Pearson Test Center. So it's a pretty interesting experience. And I just completed that about 2 months ago.
That's very cool. It's interesting that I think when online education first got started, the reason why we have separate modules in this course for online learning and MOOCs is that when online education got really got started a few years ago, MOOCs were really all the rage. It was all about these giant open courses, and we're just going to put it out there, and if we build it, they will come. But I think we're seeing more and more what you're describing of more closed, somewhat gated programs that have a monetary cost associated with them and have some kind of credential associated at the end. And we see the same thing, I think, at Coursera and here at Udacity. Can you comment on the new initiatives and those directions at those companies?
So finding putting courses together as a package like this has improved retention rates across all companies. So HBX Core has a completion rate of 85%,
wow,
which is really high for online learning. Maybe because of like Harvard's name, or maybe because of the giant like price tag, but it's really working for these companies. And across MOOCs, like the average completion rate used to be between 3% and 13%. And with nano degrees, specializations by Coursera, and the programs such as HBX Core, they've gone up to between the 60s and 80%
wow,
like completion rate, which is much more because I guess you get a degree or certification at the end. Coursera specializations are really interesting also. I've looked into the business fundamentals one that Warden is providing in collaboration with Coursera. It consists of 4 courses and a capstone project in the end. So what I really liked about it was the capstone project was designed with 500 startups, which is this very cool incubator program. It was like an opportunity to pitch to 500 startups a startup problem you're solving. However, what I didn't like about the course was that all the four courses were about big business things. So it was like about like financial accounting in a big company, or like business analysis at a big company, and not like the startup kind of problems you're trying to solve. Because as a startup, you have no data, you have nothing no finances either. So it was a bit disconnected there, but I really like where they're going with that. And I think that with Warden's backing, it may get somewhere.
Yeah. University of Maryland has one on that platform that's on entrepreneurship as well. It actually has the exact opposite thing. It covers all about funding and startup issues. And by the time you're in a company with 15 employees, specialization has nothing to say about you. It's all about getting to that initial point. So, but why do you think that there's such a move right now? I guess you already commented on it. The retention rates are higher with these specializations or nano degrees, what we do, X series on edX. Why do you think that the retention goes up when we have those kind of knit together programs as opposed to the individual courses?
I guess because each of the programs gives you a goal. HBX is trying to pitch that this is preparing you for business school. So, and that way they have a huge pipeline of students who are going to eventually apply to business school. Coursera is incentivizing students to go through the Warden specialization just to get like free Warden application at the end. So those kind of initiatives are helping, and of course Udacity and the careers. So this is, we're trying to help them get like specific careers, which is great too. So I think those goals are great, and also having a cohort system of students who are kind of like encouraging you and also holding you liable to complete really helps too.
Yeah, I think we see a lot of that in the OMS program as well. It's actually built in very many ways around the same model. It's a credential at the end. It's some people who join the same semester, and the semesters are long enough that you kind of have a cohort within those semesters. But I would be willing to bet, in fact, we have evidence to suggest that the courses on their own are, they're nice, but very few people take them if there's not that big credential at the end. There's something about that big external motivator that is the reason why people go to traditional college, and it sounds like they're trying to include that in some more online education initiatives, even if it means compromising the massiveness of these initiatives in the past.
So sometimes I was not very motivated during the HBX core program because I'm like, I have a full-time job. This is very difficult to do.
They can all sympathize.
10 to 15 hours a week gets hard. So what encouraged me during that time was my classmates. I became really good friends with some of them, and they would be like, okay, come on, Sia, the deadline's 2 days from now, let's get started, and those kind of things. And also, what HBX Core did very successfully that I think other platforms are trying to emulate is provided a social factor. So you can hear your classmates' responses and stuff as you go through the course. So when they ask questions and when they direct questions to you, it keeps you motivated to answer them.
Yeah.
So I think those two components really helped.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you have anything last you want to say to our online students from the perspective of either someone producing online education or a consumer of online education?
Yeah, so it's very difficult to complete courses, especially when you have other commitments. But I think everyone should find at least one friend in every class that they take to make sure that the buddy system kind of like works and everyone goes through those courses together. And I think that online education will only work if people get incentivized with those kind of social interactions. So definitely find a friend and get started on that.
Yeah, and as designers of EdTech, also design things in such a way that the people using your product or using your tools can connect with others and possibly partner with them, or even design tools that explicitly facilitate that. So many of you might be interested in computer-supported collaborative learning, where you can actually develop tools that make this kind of collaboration at a distance much more easy. I think one thing that's been very empowering to me in this program is that the online environment kind of creates this 24/7 classroom. And because of that, you always have people you can talk to, and you can always go to the classroom and find someone to chat with. And building tools that can enhance that even more, that could really improve what we do in online education. So thank you so much for talking to us, Sia.
Thanks, David.
And thank you all for watching.